Morning. Sometimes you get so frustrated at home that you feel like you can climb up the wall. And so today, we are going to climb the wall. We're going to go and climb a rock. We're going to do a route that we have done before. It's not particularly spectacular, but it's got a nice view of town. And we're going to go through some rough terrain. Hope you guys are enjoying it. Using my point and shoot this morning, so it will be a bit shakerish, should possibly be, but at least it will also be a bit more clear perhaps than the GoPro. See, there's a buck here, but let's climb up this piece of rock here. Let's climb up the wall here. Let's climb up the wall and have a nice view of town. This is one of the most interesting parts where you don't want to slip at all. You don't want to slip. Any people here at Waterworks will think I'm bloody nuts, you know. And we're going up steeply, and the steepest part of this section's been done, and in the space of a few minutes from home, we've got a view of town. And we're going through the Bosorosis. And we're going through the beautiful wattle trees. Yes, we are climbing up the wall today. I felt like I could just climb up the wall. So we're climbing walls today. We're climbing walls. Another short view of town. We are going to get ons gaan nou by 'n afdelingkie kom waar 'n mens meer van die dorp kan sien. En die huise in die dorp. Die huise. En die wattelbome wat so oorneem hier en deur die bosrasies problemasies bekrasies. En wat is boendo bashing in Afrikaans? Dis wat ons doen, ons doen boendo bashing. Biggie boendo bashing. You know how much better I feel already? Just from this bit of climbing. Feel a lot better. A lot better. And we're going up the rocks and through the wattle trees that weren't here before the fire. And the beautiful weeds. Millions of weeds. And ek het mos gesê, dit gaan nie noodwendig die mooiste stukkie pad wees nie, maar dis die uitsig wat dit die moeite werd maak, die uitsig. En as ons bo is, dan gaan ons met dieselfde route afstap as wat ons opgekom het die vorige keer toe ons opgekom het hier. Ons het hierdie sirkel al gedoen, maar van die teenoorgestelde kant af. So vandag is het rotse eers af met woud, mooi stuk woud wat later kom, eerder as op met woud af met klippe. En ons gaan op, skerp op, baie skerp op. Ons gaan deur die bosse. En ons wil nie gly hier nie. Anders is dit 50 meter af. Yes. Yes, we can do it. I was not going to sit in my room and do absolutely nothing. Looking at figures on the TV, that can be very frustrating. Like I said, makes you feel like you can climb up the wall. So we're climbing up a wall, just to feel a bit better. Now, look at this. This is just bushes and bushes. And more bloody bushes. Bosse rasies, problemasies, dikke rasies. Unbelievable. This used to be a lovely spot for the baboons. They used to love it here. Finally, we have the town, die dorp. Nou kyk ons af op die dorp, maat. Ons kyk nou af op die dorp. En klein stukkie son aan die ver kant daar by die industriële gebied. Blykbaar verkies baie fotograwe skaarwee. Ek weet nie, ek het gemengde gevoelens daaroor. Ek kan nie my mind opmaak vir dit verkies teenoor son nie. Jy krijg natuurlijk ook the golden owl, val ek amper hier af. The golden owl, half uur voor zonsondergang of zonopkomst tot een half uur nadat. Kan van die mooiste foto's gesien. Kijk maar op baie mooie foto's. En dit is waar jy gewoonlik meeste van hulle sien, die tyd wat hulle geneem is, is half uur voor sonopkomst of sonondergangs tot half uur na. En ek wil nie gly hier nie. Net gauw een foto neem, ek is nou by julle mense. Nou. Die foto's is geneem van die dorp. Dit was die hele doelpunt van hierdie stukkie stap. Mooi uitsig oor die dorp. Die karretjies, die huisies, aftreeoord. See aan die verkant. Waterwese aan die kant. So ver soos wat die oog kan sien. My buurt hier tenminste. Al die bome is natuurlijk in die pad van wat ons nou nie met plek is soos Tommelsdrift, Glenberry, Heatherpark, Heatherlands, is alles aan die kant. En dit kan ons nie van hier af sien nie. Daar is die bouwers. Ek het nou by hulle gekuier. Net hulle bou net oorkant ons. Ek het vir hulle vertel, vir hulle probeer wys waar precies ek gaan wees. Kyk na die rooi dak in die middel. Net na dit. Dalk sien die mense hulle raak. Net. Dalk sien hulle ons raak hier. Right, bosse rasies. Bush bashing. And then into the forest. But some serious bundu bashing through here first. Through the weeds and the wattle trees. Now, let's see if we can find a little doorway that leads us into the forest, yeah? Down onto this wattle tree we step, yeah? And we buck down, and then we have another look at the bosse rasies, yeah? And we wonder what the best option here is going to be. I have to say, this is a total contrast. You know what? I've stumbled upon this lead again and I'm going to take it for myself. I want this lead. I like it. Nobody else knows about it, so now it's mine. Thanks. A dog lead. En ons gaan weer die toe gegroeide stukjes wattelbome. En ons probeer deurkom hier, laat ons by die woud kan kom. Yes. Don't know if there's poison ivy here. There is, I don't think I'm allergic to it. Yes. Yes, we've made it to the decent forest here. We've made it to the decent forest. What a contrast. Indigenous forest that cannot look better, healthy, versus that bosse rasie stuff there that we had to come through. you know what, maybe I should just keep quiet and we might actually have a chance of seeing a sekerbekkie or two. Ach, what am I saying? Nice Naluri. I'm sure we might see a nice Naluri. Nice Naluri, Luri. So we're gonna nice Naluri see. Nice Naluri see. Listen to the wind. Listen to the wind. I'll be back now, I just want to take a photo. Let me just check the time, yeah? Just after 10. Johan has invited me for a ride today. I'm looking forward to that. I'm sure that will be quite nice. As we walk through the forest, root over rock style, a lot of bonsai formations, and you want to make a bonsai, you get a root over rock style that you can try and create. There's now just a big tree, root over rock. This year is healthy, and thanks to the fact that it's indigenous here, the fire basically stopped at the edge, which is about there, and all that greenish bright green stuff up there is weeds. That's where the fire stopped. Here it didn't burn, there it burnt up to that, and that's why you have weeds there. And there's something about indigenous that doesn't burn so easily. Take a pine tree and a wattle tree, they're the first that will burn. Mens kan duidelik sien, daar is 'n soort van 'n voetslandpaadjie nog. Daai enetjie daar. Ek gaan 'n foto neem van hierdie. Dan is daar nog een daar. Ek kan julle waarborg. Ek gaan nie water in daai stroompie nou wees nie. Die ander stroompie waar ons nou die dag was. Dit is mooi hier in die woud, nie. Ons doen so 'n bietjie van 'n 360. Klank gaan rof wees met hierdie wind, so ek moet 'n bietjie harder praat, miskien net in geval. Miskien moet ek glad nie praat nie. It's meditating up here. Very meditating. Probably a nice area to just bring a book. There's a book that, funny enough, I don't read a lot actually. I don't know why, but I'm not like the rest of my family. I don't read a lot. I wish I did, because there's no doubt this would be one of the best places to just come and park, bring my hammock, in fact, that would make it even nicer, and come and hang in the forest here. Literally hang in the forest. Weet niet of jullie dat gaan zien, maar daar is die dorp tussen die bomen, tussen die blaren. Ja, zwaar. I like this talking actually. I'm sorry if I'm talking won't take the boss here. But like I was saying, it feels like blogging to me. Whereas if you're not saying anything and you're just recording what's in front of you, then you tend to wonder, is it going to be boring? Is it not? Like blogging, just feel like talking today. Look at that, Strompie is daar. Nie so die water nou gehoor het as dit daar was, maar daar is nie water nie, so ons hoor het nie. Nog een mooie foto wat kom, ek is nou by julle. En nou gaan ons redelijk skerp af hier. Hier is ook altijd een van my gunstelinge goeikies. Kyk hoe ingevleg is alles hier. Ek weet nie wat het is nie. Dat is mooi. So, totaal en al ingevleg tussen mekaar. Ek het al foto's hiervan geneem. En nou, aftreinspoort toe. Treinspoor tussen treine, tussen stasies, leerbasis. Nerilie spore tussen treine, tussen stasies, nerilie spasies in ons verlore. It's also blogging, just singing. Wat is die ander, wat is die ander lekkie van die treine, daar's tussen treine, tussen stasies, tussen treine, as die trein aan Maatjiesfontein, help my uit, trein aan Maatjiesfontein, tussen treine, tussen stasies, dat is nog jyne, so ou liekie, ook iets te doen met treine. Ek sal nou daar miskien daan denk. Tussen treine, tussen stasies, leerbasies, perilie spore, tussen treine, tussen stasies, nerilie spasies, jou sonde verloore. Mees
Sorry, Maria, so ver van my hart, maar ek hoop om haar weer te sien. Sy het in die week van die vier gewoon, nog voor die oorlog het begin. O, bring my terug naar die Transvaal, daar waar my Sari woon, daaronder in die melies by die groen oringboom, daar woon my Sari Mare. Verlossing het gekom en die huis toe gaan was daar, terug na die oude Transvaal. Lieverlingspersoon sal seker ook daar wees om my met een kus te beloon. O, bring my terug na die oude Transvaal, daar waar my Sari woon, daaronder in die melies by die groen doringboom, daar woon my Sari Mare. Daaronder in die melies by die groen doringboom, daar woon my Sari Mare.
I still cannot think of that other one of the train. Ach, wel. Ja, swaar. This is blogging. This is feeling better. Talking into a camera. It's not like I actually have a million subscribers, unlike Joe, the guy I've spoken about before, who goes camping, the Canadian guy. But I can bet your bottom dollar, the money he makes, he would still have gone camping, even if he didn't start making money through his camping videos. It's just the money came afterwards, and he likes his camping. Goes and sets up his tent. By the way, quite true what a guy said in response to a comment I left on Facebook about aiming to go and do Tierkop again. En soos die ou gesê het, dis waar wat hy gesê het. Ek kom toe agter hy werk vir Sandbox, toe ek na sy profiel kyk. En eintlik het die mense permit nodig. Ek is verskriklik lus om dit op die regte manier te doen vir 'n slag en 'n permit te kry. Mens kry blykbaar nog 'n ding soos 'n wild card. Get a wild card. En daar's verskillende opsies met hierdie wild card. Hang af van die kostes. Elke Sandbox reservoir kan jy gaan besoek vir 'n jaar, of Cape Nature, daar's 'n ander opsie vir iets soos 21 of 28 Cape Nature reserves wat jy kan gaan doen en gaan kuier of wat ook al, gaan kamp, wat het ook al is, soveel is wat jy wil. Die ding is met hierdie Tierkop, is een mens eintlik veronderstel, as jy dit nou op die regte manier doen, is een mens eintlik veronderstel om by die hut te gaan slaap. Maar ek sien nie kans vir die hut nie. Dis wonderlik, ek meen jy het matrasse daar binnen, so dit lyk mooi, en dit is seker baie gemakkeliker. Die probleem vir my is die volgende dagse stap, is verskriklik ver dan. Dit is hoekom ek eintlik ten spuite van die feit dat die matras baie meer gemakkeliker sou wees, met 'n prachtige uitsig wederkante toe, wederskante toe, weeskante toe. Jeez, I am English after all. Jy het uitsig na die dorp toe aan die een kant van die hut, en jy het uitsig na die volgende opvangs, na die ander kant, wat niemand van die dorp af sal sien nie. Maar ek is amper lus om dit dan so te doen, en net gereed te wees vir baie, baie ver stap die volgende dag, want jy is nog eers aan die ander kant van die berg nie. So die volgende dag het jy nog 'n lang pad om te gaan, om oor kan die berg te gaan, om ander kant te kom, en dan
begin jou volgende stap basis. Maar ek gaan dit miskien doen. Ek moet nou net vir hulle sê, as ek dit op die regte manier doen, maar die ding is, hulle is nog toe. Can you believe it? Dink aan al die mense wat hier kom stap het, toe ons daai 3 ure gehad het, om te stap. Dit wil sê, almal het eintlik die wet gebreek, want Sandbox of Cape Nature is eintlik nog wetlik gesproke, is hulle nog toe. So, ja, yeah, I might just can do it one day. What I mean is, I have done it. I might just can do it the right way. Here's the lead that I scored. There's over some, it's clearly meant for some large dog. And we're going off the trail. And we're going on to civilization again. Not something I was playing. By the way, I know my teeth look terrible. They really do. They, thanks to all this medication that I've had to take for about over 40 years now. Not about, definitely over 45 years, 48 years now. They make my teeth look exactly the same as people that have been on tick, for instance, other drugs. Just happens to be also drugs, illegal drugs, tick and heroin and stuff. Well, not heroin, think of it now. That's why my bloody teeth look so terrible, because I've been drinking over 10 tablets a day for over 40 years. So if anybody's got some false teeth for me, please let me know. I will appreciate it. And you can post it to me. Thanks. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Anybody that may have seen this, because I enjoyed it. And I'll see you soon again.